Hi everyone. In this video, I am going to show you how to find duplicate characters in a string. What's a duplicate character? So a character which is repeated more than once in a string is called a duplicate character. So we are going to write a logic now to find the duplicate characters in a string. And for that, we are going to use a hash map. So a hash map is an object which stores values in key value pair. And how we are going to use this hash map is, we are going to read each character from the string, and each character we are going to add it as a key, and value will be using it to track the count of the number of times this character is repeated. So and finally, what happens once we read all the characters from the string? So we'll be having this map with keys as all the characters in the string and values as the actual number of times each character is repeated. So finally, we'll write a condition to have like how many characters has the value greater than one. Then we are going to print such characters, as those are the actual duplicate characters in a string. So for that, let me create a new class. We'll name it as find duplicate characters. We'll take the main method. I'm going to write a method here, new method, public static void. We'll name my method as, we wanted to print duplicate characters, right? So we'll name it as print duplicate characters. Which takes one argument string. We are going to call this method from the main method. We'll pass the input string to it. And the first thing we are going to do here is, I'm going to convert this string into character array. String dot, for that I'll use toCharArray method, which actually converts my input string into the character array. Now we have the string character array. Now what we are going to do here is, we'll first declare the hash map. So for that, I'll use interface map, which actually stores key as character and value is integer. We'll name my map object as charMap, and we'll instantiate to the hashMap class. Character is the key and value is my integer. All right, so map, just import it from javautil package. Hash map also should be importing it from java.util package. Now we'll write an enhanced for loop where we'll read each character from the char array. We wanted to read character by character from this array. And we wanted to check a condition. What's the condition is, if this char map contains key. What does contains key method return is, so it returns a boolean value. So if the value which you are passing, it's, you need to pass the key value. So if this value or if this key already exists in the map, then it returns true, or else it returns false. So let's take the false condition and see what we need to do. If the character is not present in the char map, we wanted to add that character into the map. So for to add a value to the map, we use a method called put, and we need to pass the key. Key here is the character, and the value which I am going to pass it here is 1, as this character is not there in the map. How did we find that? So this contains key, it returns false if the key is already not present in the map. So for that condition, what we are doing here is, we are going to add this character to the map, and we are going to assign the value as 1, as this is the first time the character appeared in the string. Now what happens if it's already there? So the key is already there. Now how are we going to handle? Again, we'll use the same put method, and then we'll add this, the same key. So what happens if we add the same key here is, so hash map doesn't allow the duplicates, But what happens if you try to add the same keys, the new key will be replaced with the old key will be replaced by the new key. So that is what happens here. And then what's the value? We don't know the count, the number of times this character. So the count of number of times it actually appeared in this string. So what we are going to do for that is we are going to get the current value for this key. And then whatever may be the current value, we are just going to add one to it, as now it appeared from the string. So we are going to add one to it. We can just add one to it. So this is the logic. And if it doesn't exist, then we are just going to add the key to the map. And as it is appearing for the first time, we are providing the value as one. If it's already present, we'll just add one to the existing value. This is the logic. And once we are done with this for loop, we'll have a map, char map, which have like characters in the key, and the corresponding value tells us the count of number of times each character appeared. And we wanted to actually, once we are done with this, we wanted to print this the duplicate characters. So we can say duplicate characters in the string. And for that, we'll again loop it. And for that, what I'm going to do here is we'll actually get all the keys. For that, we'll use a method called keyset. So on the map, if you use keyset map, it returns us all the keys, only keys from the map. And we know keys are the actual characters. So for each character, say for example, maybe CH here. For each character in this keyset, so as keyset returns me keys, and we know each key is a character. So for each key, what we wanted to do for each character, we wanted to check a condition first. What's the condition? If char map dot get of this key, so get of key returns us the actual value, corresponding value for that key. So if it is one, if it is greater than one, then we wanted to print such character. So CH is the character, and we'll just say something like it appeared. How many times it appeared? Char map dot get of key returns us the actual value, how many times it appeared, and we'll just say it as times. And we wanted to call this method from the main method. So let's call this from the main method. And where do we get this input string from? Let's read it from the console using scanner class object. System.in. Import this scanner class from Java util package. Then declare a string object where we'll read the input string using s.next method. We'll pass that string object to the R method, print duplicate characters method. And just for our readability, let's have something printed here, enter a string. And we wanted to close this scanner class object. Let's close this object once we are done with printing all the duplicate characters in the string. All right, let's execute this now. Let me provide some string as some banana. And you can see here, duplicate characters in the string. So A appeared three times, you can see it here, and N appeared two times. That's what we wanted to find out. And we can try it out with another input, like something like programming. You can see here, R appeared two times, G appeared two times, and M is also appeared two times here. So this is how we can write a logic to print duplicate characters in a string. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.